Welcome back. You are still watching Saloon Talk. We have reached the last segment, and I've been in the company of the beautiful ladies all the way from Miss Tourism, and they've been telling us what it is to be a Miss Tourism in this day-to-day life and what it is to be a modern woman. So you people, if you are there out there and you're scared of achieving your dreams, you're scared of achieving your goals, I do not know what you're thinking, because we have living legends of what you think about can actually come true, what you dream about can actually become a reality. So we're not gonna jump into questions because I think we've exhausted everything, but you're gonna like, everybody of you is gonna talk to the girls, the young girls out there who really want to join the pageantry regardless, but most especially Miss Tourism. But they are scared, or it requires this, it requires all that, it requires, and there are those who are out there, like I said, there is this bias that being in a pageantry, you're going to be having men wanting special attention from you just in order to get something. So you feel free to tell them what they should expect and how fun it can actually be.
Well, to any girl out there, you want to shine, please take up the platform. Pageantry is a platform that would probably push you out and give you a platform to showcase who you are. Do what you do best. We have talent shows. Probably you are a dancer out there and you've not had platform. This is a place for you. So I encourage any kind of girl out there, if you really want to do this, if you want to be a queen once in your life, please, this is a platform for you. There is a mindset we normally have that when you're going for any pageant, Miss Uganda, Miss Tourism Uganda, you should be more of a kind of girl, you know, those fancy girls and all that. But I promise you, it's nothing close to that. That's just what society paints it as, but it's not actually what it is.
Yeah, my advice is that you do not have to feel scared, because pageantry is not about the body physique, but it's about they check about your intellect, your poise, the way you put yourself together and all that. So you do not have to be scared about maybe body shaming and all that, but to just, you know, I was going to say to put your balls together, but since we're ladies, we are not.
To the listeners, to the ladies, to the women out there, as the topic of today, we were on modern women. Honestly, it's a nice journey to join pageantry, but then depending on the outside perception about pageantry, I think you need to hear this, and let's clear this off, that to join in, you don't need any big qualifications. You're a woman, you're a lady, you want stand up, be this upright woman, go for what you want, and then there's nothing to carry so much, really, that I need this, I need that, I need a good body, I need a good color, I need... No. It's come as you are, bring yourself, and then they will teach you definitely what to do. Because Miss Tourism, first of all, Miss Tourism Uganda is a home away from home, if I may say. Because being there, you don't even miss home so much, honestly, because they take good care of you. Imagine. Honestly, pageantry gives you a platform to express yourself, to explore places. Honestly, I reach places I'd never been. And then see me now, maybe we'll be on TV. And then this is something like, it's not easy to reach. But check, this is a platform really that pushes you. Like, it doesn't bring you in the plate, but then it shows you how to reach there.
You have heard from the beautiful ladies all the way from the Miss Tourism Uganda, and they have told you a little bit of their experience, what they went through, what they are going to do after handing over the crown. And also, you out there, you are inspired by these beautiful ladies to take up what you really want. They are an inspiration. They are a real life, how should I call it, real life avatar, is it? They are a real life of everything that you can achieve. If you set your minds to something, you are able to achieve it. Thank you, ladies, for coming through. I am so happy to have hosted you today. After here, where are you planning to go? Are you having some Miss Tourism projects to carry out, or you're gonna like go home first, relax, sleep, watch some Netflix?
Actually, after this, we're going to, for our preparation, we're going to Gulu, Northern Uganda. We have shows there running, and then we will have to join in the Let the Power Shine project. Yeah.
Tiresome. Don't you get tired at some point? You'd be like, these people are overworking me. I'm moving from place to place. Like, don't you guys get tired?
It's actually something we love to do. Tourism is moving from one place to another within 12 hours or 24 hours for pleasure. Imagine pleasure. So we just go for pleasure. It's something we love to do. So we don't have to, we don't really say, these people are overworking us and all that. It is pleasure. We love it.
Okay. As we are signing out, you're going to remind the viewers your name and you, like, your current position in Miss Tourism. Yes, before we sign out.
Actually, mine is more than a name. Mine is more than a name.
Oh, okay. Yes. All right. No problem.
Let me put this down. So, once again, my name is Alaba Charity, Miss Tourism Northern Uganda. As a Miss Tourism Northern Uganda, I urge everyone in Uganda to come to the northern region. I believe a big percentage of the Ugandans and tourists do not exceed the central region, the Jinja, or the western side. But a few people just go to Karamoja and the northern region. And I believe because of the LRA war, they have a mindset that the northern people are hostile. So I want to let you know that from me, we are not hostile. We are not hostile. We are very hospitable people. So I urge you to come to Northern Uganda to tour around, because we have tourism sites available. We have the Atiak Forest Reserve. It has black and white colobus monkeys. The youths love water. We have beautiful, romantic, magnificent waterfalls, and that is the Aru Falls campsite. So when you come to Gulu, and then you head to Pade, that is where we find the Aru Falls campsite. We have hills that you have to hike. Yes, I said you have, because it is good for your soul. It is good for your soul to hike and experience new places. So when you come to Northern Uganda, we have all these goodies. Perhaps you might be worried about accommodation. Mm-mm. The hoteliers did a very good job. We have hotels that have swimming pools. We have hotels that have ACs, and so much more that you can find in hotels, massage parlors and all that. And then you might be maybe wondering over, maybe you want to sleep in a grass thatched hut or something like that. We also have grass thatched houses that have modern amenities. So you sleep in your grass thatched house, and it is self-contained. It has AC, but it is grass thatched. So do not hesitate to come to the northern region, because we have all these goodies. Maybe you're worried about what you will eat. We also have the matoke that you love. We have the vinyewa that you love. And then the delicacies that are in the northern, I think most of you know malakwang. But we have something called olel. My God, when you taste it, heaven on earth. We have agira. Jesus Christ. I cannot explain this, because you'll not even test it when I'm just talking. It is good to explore and experience it. That is how you'll tell that this is something here that feels like heaven on earth. So it is a place that you need to really check out and explore, because it carries a lot of history that is very important in Uganda. So please come to Northern Uganda, because we have goodies for you. Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much, Leon and Aturinda, first runner up Miss Tourism Chigezi. Well, I'm from the hills of Chigezi, where we have the beautiful hills, we have Lake Winyonyi, we have the mountain gorillas, we have Mount Mugahinga, we have Mugahinga. Okay, it's so much in Chigezi. And I promise you one thing about Chigezi: no place is as cold as Chigezi in Uganda. It's a place you should visit, it's a place you're supposed to be, the sweetest land of Uganda. Thank you so much.
Hi, once again, Naken Fatima, my name's second runner, Miss Tourism Karamoja. You're welcome to Karamoja. the land of mighty warriors. We have a national game park there, that's Kidepo. We have two game reserves, that's Pian Upe and Bokora Madeniko. We have just a lot. You're welcome. Thank you.
All right, so we have reached the end of the show. You know, we are running late. The minutes are counting, and you know, these beautiful ladies have to work. You know, every minute and every second counts. You have been watching Saloon Talk. We are here every Sunday from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. right here on Upper TV. So make sure you tell a friend to tell a friend to tune in. And also, remember, we talk about topics that people do not want to talk about. We cover topics that people out there are biased of talking about. We are going to be covering with different celebrities, with different influential people that we have in the country. So stay tuned for more topics. If you have any comment you want to tell us, you can go down to our social media platforms. We are here at Spectra Saloon Bukolobi. If you want to get your hair done, if you want to get your nails done, if you want to get your beard done, if you're a man, you want to get a facial, you want a massage, Spectra Saloon has everything for you. Do not be underestimated by the small size of the dough. Trust me, the saloon is very big and vast within. So make sure you come down through. Your hair is going to get styled. I don't think we're going to get the time to show you my workout hair, but hopefully the producer can get a cutaway and you guys see the products that this saloon uses and what you are going to get. Though your money is worth everything that you want to look for. So make sure you're tuned in every Sunday from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. You're watching Saloon Talk. I'm your girl, Savara Hughes. Feel free to follow me on all my social media platforms. That is Savara Hughes 53, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat. Yeah, Snapchat people. Now we are people nowadays, you know, Snapstreak. Anyway, catch you again next week with another episode. Stay tuned.